things that we take for granted, the safety of your house, the peaceful sleep. You never think about stuff like that until you hear that this can happen into the 21st century. My name is Kristina Snyder and I work here at Mercy Gastroenterology. I grew up in Ukraine. I love the capital. I think it's one of the most beautiful cities. In 2008, I immigrated to the States to go to school to be a nurse practitioner here. I've been with Mercy since about 2012 in various positions. This past week, obviously everyone knows, has been pretty nerve-wracking. I do have family in Ukraine. My aunt lives in Odessa and I have two cousins there. Each of them have families as well, about my age. I do remember calling my aunt. We were ready to go to sleep and I couldn't stop crying. And so surprisingly, we actually were able to communicate, have been able to communicate using, you know, just like the Viber or one of those like a FaceTime apps. They did say that there were some explosions that first night. Initially they thought that they wouldn't it wouldn't progress anywhere, so they kind of stayed, but then I think the next day they actually packed some bags and left for Moldova, and they just left their house behind. It is so scary, and like you don't hear a 36 year old guy just saying things like that. So that was horrible. He couldn't sleep for like I think 2 days before they left the house. This is war and things happen, so nobody can predict what, you know what I mean, where that next bomb goes. I also have a sister who lives in Crimea, 2 hours from northern border, which obviously everyone knows now this is the annexed territory by Russia. They can't stop hearing the shots and bomb explosions. One of my other aunts in Crimea have saying that, you know, the planes just cannot stop flying. Like it's such a constant noise that she said that you see things like that in the World War II movies. I don't think anyone actually believed that this would happen, to, you know, have to descend to a basement to sleep so you don't get hit by a bomb. And you just need to keep in mind also that most of our houses or apartments are high rises, so you're really not that protected up there, you know. I think Ukrainian people actually do show amazing courage, and I can't imagine what I would do to protect my homeland and my own people and my family, for sure. And I think they have been pretty remarkable. I pray every night and I wake up and I check the news and hoping that this is all over and it was just a nightmare. And that's how it felt for a few days. I've had patients asking and I've had very sweet, you know, obviously people kind of follow up and making sure that my family is good, which I think is really, really nice. You know, people who watch news, they know what's going on, and just keep Ukraine in its prayer. And again, civilians, normal people, regular people who don't have any interest in any kind of a political games, just give them strength and the perseverance. We may feel helpless, but I think prayer is obviously much more powerful than it may feel at this time.